Israel, and Iraq. Participating in the panel are three extraordinarily knowledgeable gentlemen who don't really need much of an introduction. We'll go in the order, in the following order. We'll start with Cengiz Çandar, followed by Congressman Robert Wexler, and finishing up Karim Sajapour from the Carnegie Endowment. I believe you all have their bios, so I won't spend too much time introducing them. I'll just say that we'll have a maximum of 10 minutes for remarks in order to maximize the time for Q&A from the audience. So with that, I ask my good friend, Cengiz Çandar, to begin with Turkey and Iraq. Thank you.
Thank you, Steve. I hope that I'll abide by this 10-minute constraint, which is a real constraint to what I intend to say. But before starting, I just want to make sure that the design of my tie with elephants is not a political statement. I'm aware where I am. It has been a very touchy capital, Washington, and in less than a day, I got aware that the prime minister of the country I come from, Turkey, Tayyip Erdogan, is less popular than he is in Turkey, in Washington. And it seems the main reason of his diminishing popularity, which is also simultaneous, that Turkey is not a very popular world. As we heard earlier, it just reflects the feelings of disappointment or displeasure when the word is pronounced Turkey. Has something to do with the name, with the title of the conference, Turkey's New Geopolitics, Challenges and Opportunities, and it is exactly this new geopolitics brought up the issues we are addressing, which occurred in the last few weeks between Turkey and Israel, between Turkey and concerning the Turkish vote in UN Security Council. But it is amazing to me that the title of this conference, Turkey's New Geopolitics, Challenges and Opportunities, was exactly word by word the title of an article I had co-authored with Graham Fuller 10 years ago, which I was a resident in this town, and we wrote that article, and if we would be brought here, we wouldn't have such an eminent audience in front of us which would be attracted by this Turkey's new geopolitics challenges and opportunities, while now the case, seeing you as the audience, such an eminent audience here we have, means that in the last decade the world and with it Turkey has undergone a real change which brought up this title as a very attractive issue to be debated. So during the course of this last debate, Turkey's policies, Turkey's conceptions changed parallel to the changes in the global scale and in the regional scale. And by the organizers of this conference, I was asked to underline the Turkish-Iraq policy, and particularly the Turkey's relationship with the northern part of Iraq called the Iraqi Kurdistan. So touching upon Iran and Israel issues in general, I will try to focus on this part of the issue. So to simplify, to perhaps sound bites, what has happened between Turkey and Iraqi Kurdistan within the framework of Iraq, Turkey's policy shifted or changed from being a security-oriented policy to an economy-centered, business-centered policy. I have some figures for you to bring into your attention, that Turkey's annual consumption, Turkey's consumption of oil is 500,000 barrels a day, and the yearly consumption of natural gas is 36 billion cubic meters. So the figures I will let you know is not true reserves of Iraqi Kurdistan, the north of Iraq, but strong estimates, and those are told to me by the Minister of Natural Resources of Iraqi Kurdistan Regional Government, who is one of the most prominent personalities in the oil business in Iraq. So the oil reserves of the Iraqi Kurdistan is 45 billion barrels. 45 billion barrels. Gas reserves 6,000 billion cubic meters. And the oil production, which was 100,000 barrels a day, I'm speaking only of Iraqi Kurdistan, that reached 300,000 barrels a day this year, and which is envisaged to reach to 1 billion barrels a day in the year 2013. In terms of gas, natural gas, no infrastructure for export yet, but could export if it is developed from 60 to 70 billion cubic meters a year. So this is the bonanza, stays out there. Geopolitically, in the immediate proximity of Turkey, and Turkey through democratizing, meaning lessening the impact of the military in the decision making process, political decision making process. So through it, transforming the security centered foreign policy to its neighborhood, to economy-centered foreign policy, it started to see the opportunities in front. And in that sense, the relationship has moved from hostility to rapprochement with Iraqi Kurdistan. If we should say so, from having a cold shoulder to have an inclusive relationship, which is symbolized and signified by Turkey opening a consulate in Erbil and later in October 2009, a few months ago, and which is witnessed by only a week ago of the Iraqi Kurdistan President Barzani's visit to Turkey, first in the last 8 years. So these all follow the Baghdad encounter of Turkey's prime minister visit, which I was also there, that he went with 10 ministers, nearly 50%, half of the Turkish cabinet, with busload of businessmen and bureaucrats and journalists. An Airbus 310 landed upon Iran, and they signed 48 agreements in one day, ranging from environment to infrastructure investments, from security to trade. And in the press conference the Turkish Prime Minister Erdogan had with his Iraqi counterpart Maliki, he declared that from now on, that's October 2009, we are two states with one government. Then Turkey was involved in bringing up the Sunni groups under a Shiite prime minister, former prime minister who is a secular Shiite, as you all know, Iyad Allawi. And Turkey was instrumental in forming the Iraqi list that proved to be having the highest votes in the Iraqi elections recently. So parallel to these developments, Turkey lifted visa requirements with Syria, Lebanon, and Jordan, and only a week ago it signed a free trade zone agreement which brought these four countries together. And interestingly, these four countries constitute the same region of the Ottoman Empire called the Damascus Province, or in Turkish, Sham Province. So there was a catchword in a joking way saying that vis-à-vis the Schengen regime of the European Union, now we have the Schengen regime of our own.